Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. Fish and Game officers have recovered the body of a fisherman reported missing along the Saco River in Conway. The man's body was found just before midnight, about 1,600 feet upstream from his car. Officials say he died of natural causes. An emergency hearing is being held today for the man accused of kidnapping North Conway teen, Abby Hernandez. Nathaniel Kibbe's lawyers are concerned about moving their client's house in a storage container off his Gorham property. But the state says that evidence would be safer in another location. Investigators have focused on both structures ever since Kibbe was arrested, and police have spent hours searching them. Now the state wants to move the trailer and a container there to a secure location in order to preserve the evidence. Prosecutors say the only other option is to provide 24-hour security. But the defense claims that by moving the evidence, the crime scene may be tainted. Kibbe's lawyers also argue that because the paperwork in the case has been sealed, they have limited information, making it difficult to build a defense.
They don't know what evidence is going to be offered against Mr. Kibbe yet, so they want the court to just make sure that everything is preserved as it exists today. The AG's argument essentially is we're doing what we think is required to preserve the evidence. Otherwise, they'll be left out in the elements, and any type of trace evidence that might be there now might be lost.
The defense has also asked that Hernandez's medical records, notes, phone records, and audio recordings be protected. Attorney David Ruoff says that part of the motion will likely be granted, but that the state is likely to get its way with the buildings. A probable cause hearing in the case is scheduled for next week as well. Scary moments for two people in Pembroke last night. They had to be rescued from the Suncook River. Witnesses called for help when they spotted a man struggling in the water behind an apartment building. A bystander jumped in to help and also had to be rescued. This section of the Suncook River has steep rock walls, making it difficult to get out on your own. Firefighters lowered a ladder to the bystander, who was able to climb out. They used ropes, a pulley system, and a basket to reach the man who had been struggling in the water. That man was taken to the hospital to be checked out. The two-star general killed in a shooting in Afghanistan yesterday has ties to New Hampshire. General Harold Green is the highest-ranking American officer killed in combat since 1970 during the Vietnam War. He has ties to New Hampshire. The 34-year veteran of the Army, General Green attended elementary school in Nashua, where his father taught at the high school. He also previously served as the commanding general of the Natick Soldier Systems Center in Massachusetts.
I was kind of speechless for a few minutes. Then the realization is like, wow, you know, he is a really nice guy, a good person, a good commander, and something terrible happens. It's sad.
General Green was an engineer by training and was on his first deployment to a war zone. He was helping prepare Afghan forces for when U.S. coalition troops leave at the end of the year. The owner of a campground in Warren has been warned to make sure dumpsters are locked up and secure because bears are making a habit of looking there for food. State Fish and Game officials say they have had problems with the owner of the Moose Hillock Campground for the last 14 years. And now bears are so used to finding food there, they are difficult to scare away, and they're even raiding campsites. The owner has been given 2 weeks to get new dumpsters that the bears cannot get into. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.